Sudan, this mid-range North Korean ballistic missile. Tell us about its reach and its capability.
Well, the Musudan is technically classified as an intermediate range ballistic missile. It can travel 3,500 to 4,000 kilometers, which puts Guam and the large Marine Corps and Air Force base on that island within range of the missile. It can probably carry a nuclear warhead. From what we've seen that North Korea has shown us, it is quite possible that they could make something small enough to fit on a missile of that size.
You mentioned the Musudan is capable of hitting Guam. That's where U.S. forces are based. Up next, let's talk about the Pukguksung-1, another North Korean missile that's been tested, a newer type intermediate range ballistic missile. It's submarine launched, and it's also solid fueled. Why is that significant?
The Pukguksung-1 is significant for two reasons, as you mentioned. Firstly, it's a submarine-launched missile, which gives the North Koreans, theoretically, a second strike capability. What that means is that in the event of tensions or hostilities on the Korean Peninsula, they could put the submarines out to sea, and it would be hard for us to find that submarine. And then, even if we destroyed all of their land-based missile, they would still have at least one nuclear weapon in reserve. Secondly, as a solid-fueled missile, it is much easier to store. Unlike the Norse liquid-fueled missiles, they can store it fueled, which means that it is easier to transport and it needs less support equipment. We've also seen this missile.
Easier to avoid detection, too. And how worrying are these, as they're called, submarine-launched ballistic missiles? Are North Korean submarines difficult to detect?
Well, North Korea's submarines are all what we would call diesel-electric submarines. They can travel slowly underwater on battery power for perhaps a day or more, very quietly. But after that, they have to come near the surface and recharge the batteries with a noisy diesel engine. Also, we've only seen one of these submarines so far, and it only has one missile tube, so it's hard to really consider this an operational capability rather than something they're working on still.
Got it. So far, we talked about two missiles that have been tested. There's a lot of attention, a lot of discussion on intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs. These are the missiles that could, if successful, actually reach the mainland of the United States. Your thoughts now on when will North Korea actually test fire an ICBM?
Well, technically, they could probably test fire one tomorrow or today. They've had the missiles on display since 2012. We've seen Kim Jong-un touring locations where they have the missiles stored and they look real. So they could test one next week, they could test one next year. But part of the problem is that for them, testing an ICBM would be very politically costly because they would see a lot of new sanctions from us and from other countries. And it would also use up a lot of fuel. And the question is, when will they be willing to take that risk?
Got it. So, I mean, technically, they're able to test fire, as you said, an ICBM in just a matter of days or months. The roadblock here, the stumbling block, is cost, but also the intention here of wanting to test fire an ICBM. It's the main reason for having one of these things, not to put a conventional weapon on it, but to actually put a nuke on it, to actually launch a nuclear strike.
Well, one thing I would add on testing is also that there's not necessarily any guarantee that it would succeed. If we go back to the Musudan for a moment, they've test-fired that at least six times in the past 2 years, and it has only succeeded once. So some of the ICBMs they've shown us, which use similar technology, are not necessarily going to be very